in For the Kids news submitted by Up Up and Away. The border crisis is really getting out of hand.
Aww.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Appropriate.
Aww. It sucks.
It does suck, though.
Yeah.
What about the children?
Exactly. All right. Sorry, so anything that Joe says right now is funny as fuck. I don't know why.
I think he's being genuine.
Maybe.
I know. It's just the way
that he sounds comical.
You know what's sad? I know. I just expressed myself pretty fucked up. But I just saw this video of a lot of Japanese Americans who were children in the internment camps. And they were protesting these different like centers, right? And then there's this video of like a military police guy coming out, and he was just trying to like, he's treating civilians as if they're like privates, and like he's just yelling at them, and he's like, "What do you people not understand? You can't protest here." And he's like being fucking gangster, like he's being mean to them, right? I get it, like you could talk like that to your privates and in that military setting, but you can't talk to civilians that actually were, you know, done wrong by this government.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then they're protesting against it because they don't want to have children incarcerated in these
seeing them with the foil blankets. The foil, that's what's so crazy. Like, they're sleeping on these little mattresses, you know, like mats, and then you blankets, it's foil.
Like the emergency blankets, right?
Yeah.
It just looks like foil to me.
They actually kind of
they're space blankets. They're warm.
They're really warm. Oh, okay. They're thin, but they keep you warm.
Yeah.
But they do report
that. Well, I mean, still, it's still
comfortable though. Yeah.
They do report that they are cold and that they leave the lights on when they're trying to sleep, so they can't sleep. They don't have toothbrushes or toothpaste. They don't have.
That's true.
There are children that are taking care of other children, like little kids taking care of even younger kids that aren't even related to them.
Damn it.
So there was this lawyer that visited Clint, Texas, and they went to one of the patrol stations where 255 children were being held. And so they ended up coming out with these reports saying like the living conditions there were deplorable. Like it was just so bad. Like this is not humane. And so even though the Border Patrol people, like the people in charge of the facility, were saying like, "What? It's fine. They're fine. Nothing's wrong here.
Put your kids there." Then.
Yeah.
Yeah. Exactly.
Well, maybe they have low standards, and then you go back to their house, and it's like, "Oh, no wonder you thought this is better, because it's better than their trailer park."
Fuck no. Well, it's so sad though, because they're saying that 6 migrant children have already died in these.
Oh, yeah.
What the fuck? What are they dying from?
From illnesses, because they're not being taken.
Oh shit! Out. I thought they were like jail riots and shit.
I thought a couple of them they were basically near dead when they got there.
Well, that's what they're reporting.
Yeah.
Also, they've been dehydrated. Or and then they got there and then they died.
Yeah.
So it's not the ill conditions of the
facility. I mean, that's still bad that if they're even going in that sick.
Well, no, they go in because of the journey.
Yeah. No, I get that. But I'm saying once they get to the facility now, there's no one there to tend to a kid. They're more like, well, these are just half dead anyway.
No. There's medical people there. There's doctors and nurses and shit.
Oh, I see.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what they're saying, that there is medical attention there, but the cases that 6 of them have still died, and there's still a lot of children that are
really that sucks.
With the flu. And so they're saying that there's 15 children that are sick with the flu and another 10 are in medical quarantine. But even after they're saying everything's fine, after these reports, they still removed about 30 of the 255 children from the facility, but now 2 agency officials are saying that more than 100 have been brought back. And so it's just this whole thing. And it was crazy too, because the government went to court and were talking to these judges and saying like, well, you know, the conditions here say that they have to be sanitary, or what was it? What was the quote? Do you remember the quote? Thank you. So they were saying that, you know, as long as these conditions are safe and sanitary, then it should be meeting the requirements. But then the government saying, well, how do we know that toothbrushes and soap is part of safe sanitary? Like, they're fine. So they're
what?
Like, yeah, they're pretty much saying like, you know, they're okay. They don't need any more attention. We don't need any more money to treat these kids, pretty much. So the House, they were trying to pass this bill in order to get $4.5 billion to go to these
centers.
Thank you. To go to these centers and try to help these children that are involved in this whole thing and just put the money there, right? But the Senate bill has now been passed for $4.6 billion to pay some of the costs of for the surge of migrants and also for more security at the border, because the Senate was saying, and like Trump was saying, like, you know, why, like, we can't put all this money just for helping the people that are here. We also need to put money to secure the border as well. Mm-hmm. So at least the Senate bill seems to be a little bit more fair than the House bill, because the House bill seemed to be more towards taking care of these kids.
That's so crazy. Wait, so is there just full facilities of just children? Is that what's going
on? They're separated from their parents and stuff, right?
Yeah, because...
Damn, how come they don't have family facilities? Like, this is weird.
Yeah.
Well, it's tough because a lot of the times, like, coyotes will take kids with them that aren't even necessarily their kids.
Oh,
so they try
so
to cheat the system.
Oh, so, fake
so
families?
So Border Patrol has to suss out who is who and who belongs to what, and it gets fucked up. It's so a like, very, it's a big mess. It's not just like, this is really easy to figure out. Like, it's a huge fucking
mess. That's why, because it made no sense to me why they would separate the children, but that makes a lot of sense if you're kidnapping the kid and then you're going over the border with the pretend family.
Well, there's also a legal decision behind it. It's called like the Flores decision. And this was in, I think, like 15 years ago or something. But a judge determined that you cannot keep a kid at a facility for longer than 20 days, right? So, but the parents are often there, have like they have their own trial.
To do all the paperwork and all that.
Right, stuff, yeah. So then if you can't keep a kid legally past 20 days, that's where the separation stuff happens. And so a lot of people kind of miss that in this whole thing, that there's this legal ruling they have to do this shit. So it's such a fucking disaster.
So the parents can legally be held over 20 days. So they'll be
held
still
up to 6 months, I think.
Yeah,
so they'll
be
still incarcerated while the kid gets loose, and then they're like, where do they send the kid to?
Right. So people simplify this and just go, they're separating kids from their parents, but it's like they have to. And they don't even necessarily want to.
It's just a flaw in the legal system.
Because of the Flores decision. Yeah.
Damn. That's pretty much it.
So It does seem like a big clusterfuck, because there's a lot of things that border security has to think about. Is like, is this child sex slavery? Is it drug smuggling with a pretend family? Is it an actual family and they're just trying to, get over the border?
Right.
Like, there's so many things.
Are they trying to
get
asylum? Are they trying to, are they trying to claim refugee status? There's so much shit.
Yeah.
So when they're being held in these centers, are they going like one at a time, each kid figuring out what they are, like the system, who the parents are, like, is that what this center is for? To match and put things together and then...
So the system is like, it's called catch and release right now, where like you come into the United States illegally, say.
Okay.
Right? And then, because they caught you coming across or whatever. And then a lot of times they go right up to the Border Patrol and they go, hey, I'm here. Because they want to go to these facilities to have their trial, because they want to try to claim
Affirmative asylum process.
Exactly.
Or a defensive asylum.
Exactly. So they want to have a shot at getting through, because the immigration system's so shit that it takes like 7 years sometimes to get through, or even longer. So catch and release is basically like, okay, well, in the meantime, we're going to release you into the population until your trial, because we have nowhere to house you, right?
There's
way
too many.
These centers to process people. And then a lot of times people don't show up to their court dates, because why would they if they got released?
So they just stay in the system.
Right, so that's the argument is you're catching these people and then you're releasing them into the population, so it's tough to... And then, of course, they're not going to come back to the court date. I think 9 out of 10 of them don't. So it's just such a tough thing.
Do these people know that once they arrive, these are the conditions and you might be separated from your kids and all that? Like, do they know that and they still... Because of how bad it is back home, they're willing to go through all that?
I mean, obviously, if they're willing to take their kid from their home and take them through that journey, like...
Yeah, I know that...
Like, anything's better than what's happening back home.
Well, maybe. Yeah, because it's not just Mexicans, right?
Like, like Venezuela right now, the crisis that's happening in their country, they're trying to flee to...
El Salvador.
And there's people who are, like, let's say, guerrillas took over their country and then they were a part of the government and they're just seeking asylum, like, legitimately. There's guys that are, like... Shit, it's a Caribbean nation. I forgot what it was, but I was watching this guy's story, and then he was like, "If I go back, they're going to kill me."
Oh shit!
And then so he didn't want to go back, but then he had to. So,
gotcha.
Yeah, so a lot of people, they're just desperate to be here. And it's just everyone's story is so different, right? Because there's not like one story. Like, yeah, sure, you have your criminals in the mix that are just trying to smuggle shit. But you also have just decent people trying to run away and start a new life. Like,
yeah.
And what people don't know is there's a cap for each country that's allowed to come to the U.S.
Yeah.
So if you're not the privileged and the rich, like, it's very difficult to come to the States. And they might not be even documented in their own country. They might be an indigenous group in their own country that's coming up here. And they don't even have papers from their original country.
Exactly.
Damn. Yep. Yeah, they're saying that right now, this is like the lowest amount, like the ceiling is like the lowest amount of asylum seekers that they're accepting in the history of the United States.
Right.
This happened in the 80s. Like they, in the beginning, I think it was about 200,000 people could be accepted, but now it's about 30,000 people.
And it makes sense because we're going under a population problem. So there's a lot of immigration that's happening, but in the past it was like way easier. People would just come in.
Yeah, that's true. But I don't know, man. Like right now they're also reporting that a lot of people are trying to donate diapers and toys and like toothpaste and toothbrushes to the facilities in Texas, but they're being turned away because they're saying that legally they can't accept donations. But other people are commenting back and saying like, well, yeah, you can't accept donations from actual brands because then that's kind of like bribing sort of. But from the people, like, why can't you accept it?
Like the citizens of Texas?
Yeah, exactly.
It's because of this stupid fucking law they have.
They can slide things in it or something, like contraband?
It's the ADA or something.
Yeah, it's the ADA, yeah, exactly.
Oh my God.
So they have a law, so they literally can't take the shit. Like, they even if they want to.
Yeah.
It's so stupid.
Maybe they need to drive past the border and give it to them before they cross it, so they can cross it with the diapers and the water and the toothbrush.
You know, there's groups out there that it's there's two types of groups, right, by the border, like vigilante groups. Like there's that where they just go out and they try to help migrants with water and medicine and all that. And there's another group that helps the border patrol, and they're patrolling with guns and stuff like that. Yeah, so it's interesting to see like the difference of how people try to help. Yeah.
What if the people that are passing out the water are giving the positions away? They're like, here's the water, and they have like a loud ass truck, and the border patrol's like, oh, there they are.
No, sometimes they just leave it there with a note or whatever.
Yeah.
And then like they just try to leave stuff all around.
But well, then the people crossing probably fear if it's poison too because of the other group too.
So oh, yeah, shit. Sure. Yeah, I don't even know.